Okay, so I'm not sure if this live works like the Instagram live, but if I'm live and everybody's watching, hey guys. I am Ashley, also known as the Grooming Extraordinaire, and this is my Esco, my palm, my little boo thing. So I'm so excited to be here. First and foremost, I want to thank Andrea, number one, for asking me if I would be interested in doing such a fun activity. So I'm really, really excited. I'm going to just jump right into it. Basically, today what I'm going to be demonstrating for you all is how to achieve vibrant colors on upright ears. Now, I'm going to try to get Esco to look at you guys because he's obsessed with me. But he has he has upright ears. He is a Pomeranian, one of my favorite dogs. And I'm going to actually be getting him ready for a wedding. So his mom is having a wedding. I'm so excited. She's having a winter themed wedding, which is awesome because I did the HBO show and my episode was winter themed. So this is so much fun. I'm using four different colors. I mixed two blues, and then the other two blues would be the blue black. Aquamarine, I hope you guys can see. And then I mix the innocent blue and a cobalt blue. I mix these two colors together. I have my entire station set up. I like to just prep first. Esco is completely washed and dried, so everything is already done. I do not believe in coloring a dog that is dirty. The worst mistake that you can make is coloring a dirty dog. A groomer made a statement in the OPAWZ group. She thought that dogs get sick from the chemicals if you wash their coat. Somehow it gets into their pores. Andrea and OPAWZ is such a phenomenal company. I've been working with this color for over 13 years. I've never had an issue, and it's pet formulated. So it's made for pets. It won't get them sick, I promise you. So make sure your coat is washed if you want a vibrant color. If you wash them after you color them, all of that color is going to wash off with the dirt and the oils, and it's going to be faded and it won't be vibrant. So you do the right job, get it done right, and it'll look amazing. So first thing first, when you're doing a white coat, always use conditioner. You're going to use conditioner for the base of the area so that the color doesn't stain the outside perimeter area of whatever it is that you're coloring. OPAWZ does have a perimeter. Andrea, correct me if I'm wrong. I believe they have a perimeter to avoid the stains from getting on the fur as well. I don't have it, but I'm going to make sure I get it. But for now, I'm going to use the conditioner. It's accessible to everybody. And then all you have to do is just, I put a little bit on my fingers, and I make sure I get, like I said, the perimeter of whatever you're coloring. So since I'm doing his ears, I'm gonna get the top of his head, I'm gonna get behind the ears, the nape area, and I'm gonna get the front of his face so the color isn't all over the place. He's good, he's upset because I'm not paying him attention. He knows we usually have a little bit of TLC one-on-one. You can even massage it if you want. If you guys have questions, I'm blind. I can't see that far. I'm going to try to jump back and forth to answer the questions as I go. But a little trick that I have whenever I'm coloring the ears, I like to use a toothbrush. I don't typically use, hey Jazz, hey sis. I don't typically use an applicator brush because it's a little bit too big. And when it's too big, I sometimes end up coloring areas that I'm not interested in coloring. So definitely make sure I'm trying to read and talk. Make sure you use a toothbrush. You can get them from anywhere, and we're gonna start coloring. So I'm gonna do, like, I'm a freestyle groomer. So typically whatever I do, it just comes to mind at the time. And what I want to do is I'm going to do like party ears on him. So I'm going to color his ears several different shades of blue, and I'm going to do it all throughout the ear area. So it's a, you guys will see. So I'm going to try to push him a little bit closer, hopefully so everybody can see. Oh, gloves, most important part. I like to use my free hand to do a circle around the ear. When I have the circle around the ear, although I already have the conditioner on the coat, this is just the extra protector. So when you put your fingers right around the ear, you'll be able to color. You don't have to squeeze the ear. You don't have to hold it tight. Just lightly hold the ear and get to coloring. So I hope you guys can see. I like to use my comb to comb out the areas that I want colored, and then I just get to work. Light strokes. And what I love about the toothbrush is that it allows you to just get anywhere that you want, and it actually strokes the hair strand, so your color is being applied all throughout the ear. Now, like I said, I'm doing a party mix, so I'm just jumping back and forth with my colors until I'm able to have the entire ear filled. I always recommend doing color on dogs that are quite tolerant of the process. The more tolerant they are, the easier it is for you to achieve whatever design it is that you're going to do. I think the characters are amazing. I don't really like doing it. It's like, I don't think my dog is going to tolerate me that long. But as far as like the cute elegance, that's me. The ombre, the tears, that's me. I'm gonna add one more shade of blue. With white coats, be so careful. Take your time, because the last thing you want is for the color to get all over the place. Last thing. I hope you guys can see it so far. Once I'm done applying the color, I'm going to log off of live, then I'm gonna jump back in after I wash and dry him, because it's gonna be a little bit of a process trying to get the camera to my tub. So I'm going to put him back on once I'm all done so you guys can see how the color came out. I know Jasmine is working on a dog as I'm working on this one, so I would love to know if there are any other groomers working on a dog while I'm doing this, or is everybody just taking notes? Fun fact, I loved art. Art was my favorite class. I love to color because it's just like, it's like my own little therapy session, you know? You get to sit, work magic, make them look good, make them feel good. And then the pet parents come back and they're just like, how did you do that? How can you do that? It's magic. Esco tends to fall asleep while I'm working on him. He likes to fall asleep. Let's see, bathing and drying. Okay, all right, it's all right. Listen, we all could work together while we're doing this. I'm gonna try to take my phone off so you guys can see a little bit of what I'm doing. So this is the first ear. Oh, there we go. So this is four different shades of color, and I hope you guys can see. And like I said, because I have the conditioner all on his coat, you don't have to worry about the color staining. That's the trick. Like, always put conditioner all over your dog's coat. Because if you don't and you have a white dog, oh man, I learned that the hard way my first time grooming. I wasn't knowledgeable enough yet. And I went to town on a dog, and I mean, his chin, his nose, between his eyes. His mom was so nice about it, but I felt so bad. So now I make sure that I put conditioner on the ears all the time. And on the base, anything that I'm doing, I make sure I put conditioner on. I like to play music for my dogs and for me while I'm working. We just, you know, we listen to music. Sometimes it's Afro beats. Sometimes we like to listen to our country. Sometimes we like to listen to old school. So, you know, we all pick and choose what we want to listen to. It depends on my dog's energy. If it's a hyper dog, we might listen to some Meg. Thank you. It's always about taking your time. Don't rush. I charge accordingly when I do color, especially when I'm doing things like this with multicolor or freestyle design, because it is time consuming. So don't be afraid to charge accordingly. And I always let people know, you know, color is not easy. It's not overnight, and it lasts months. Honestly, I love OPAWZ, just so you know, but it lasts very long, and you know, they get compliments left and right. So pay for what you get. That's just me. I get a lot of groomers that tells me it takes them a really long time to achieve color, but you know, people would never pay X, Y, and Z. And then I just tell them that they should never ask for color. If you want color, if you want luxury, you want something different that nobody's seen before, you know, you have to pay for it. And I'm a very big believer in paying for what you get. So if you're talented and you're taking your time and you're really creating like a masterpiece, they should pay accordingly. If there's anybody that's never ordered from OPAWZ before that's gonna be ordering, I definitely highly recommend you can use my code ASH2020. You'll save some money on amazing products. Let's go. We still working here. What you doing? I told you they are comfortable when they're getting done in here. They're like, they're not used to me talking because I'm usually working. So he's just like, Ashley, I'm boo-boo. Day. It's really hard to do color when you have like a lover dog, one that wants to like kiss you and love you. Ah, don't lick the color. No, I'm not playing. You see, because they don't take you seriously. When I start smiling and laughing, they think it's like playtime. I'm like, it's not go time. No. Day. Good boy. Don't be afraid to color, express your creativity, you know, let your mind run free. That's me. I love customers. It's just like, do what you want, Ash. And you know, this is her wedding, you know, and she's like, do what you think will look good. I'm like, for your wedding? Okay. So, you know, just run wild with your creativity. Don't be afraid, especially if it's like your first time. It's here, it'll grow back, you could cut it off. Like, just express yourself. That's it. Let me check the questions. Thank you so much. So, all right. With me and coloring, I charge based on the time it takes me. So, I charge $90 an hour, and that's additional to the haircut. So, the coloring process typically takes me anywhere from, honestly, an hour to 2.5 hours, sometimes 3, depending on what it is that I'm doing. So, So for example, I shut down the day for them because she gets a hand silhouette, which I charge for, and then she gets the color, which I charge for. So like Esco comes out to almost $250 roughly. And you know, she pays for it because she gets what she gets and it lasts. But you can charge per hour if that's easier for you. So if you want to start off at like $50 an hour or $60 an hour, You could do that. I think it's easier charging for time because like a design, you don't know how long it'll take you to do. So instead of charging for the design, it's better to actually charge for the time that it takes for you to achieve the design. And what I will say is don't do any dogs in between, because then you'll get a little confused or get a stop clock so you know how much time you're spending on your dog. There's people that charge for the design. So for example, some people are like, if you want colored paws, I charge $40 additional. You know, it depends on how long it takes, if your dog doesn't sit still, if the coat doesn't take to the color as well as I would like it to, if I have to reapply. So that's why I charge for the time that it takes me to do it, and not the design that I'm doing. I would love to know how everybody in here charges. It's fun. It's a community. We could talk so everybody can just bounce ideas off of each other. Because this is like a winter wedding, I want a little bit of his white to still show. So I'm just fluffing up certain areas. Hi, Liz. Oh, that's why I love Liz. How are you, honey? I like to just like sporadically, just do it all over the place. So this is what his ears look like. I hope everybody, can you guys see? So it's four different colors. It's aquamarine, cobalt blue, innocent blue, and black and blue. And then I did a custom color mixing the innocent blue and the cobalt blue. So we're gonna do his tail next. I'll show you guys how I do the tail. And like I said, it's a party look. So I wanted to, you know, I wanted to match the tail as well. Let's see. The tail, I always use aluminum foil. It is a heat restraint. I think one of my clients is a hairstylist. She's like, you have to learn to use like the terms. I'm like, I just like to say it really allows the hair color to stick. But she said it's like a heat restraint when you use aluminum foil on the fur so it can just really stick. You can't put aluminum foil on the ears. That's why I say do the conditioner. I've seen groomers do aluminum foil on ears, but I think those dogs probably have like really, really big standing ears. So on ears like this, you won't be able to achieve that. I'm so excited to see his wedding photos. It's gonna be so adorable. Oh my God. I love doing weddings. Like, I think once I'm done in my salon, I'm going to start doing like weddings for dogs. All right, so let's see. Here's his tail. I'm gonna change my gloves because I don't want any color to get on his tail. So I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna put conditioner on his back so the color doesn't get on his, well, no. I'm putting aluminum foil. So if you didn't wanna do the aluminum foil method, you can put conditioner on his back. But since I'm doing the aluminum foil method, I don't need to put conditioner on the back. What are you doing, boo? So can you guys see? That's cool. I hope you guys can see his ears. He's obsessed with me. This dog, I think he thinks he's my man because he has to gaze into my eyes. Let's see. My salon is, I don't know the exact square footage, but I have a huge back. I think it's like 1,100 square feet, if I'm not missing me by myself in here. It's pretty big. What factors affect how well the color takes? Let's see. Okay, so the factors, the most important factors, like I said, when it comes to coloring a dog's coat, number one, it has to be clean. You want a clean coat. Two, take the coat color into consideration. If it's a black dog, OPAWZ is great. So they have hair lifting color products, but it's gonna be a longer process. So if you've never done it before, if you have a lighter dog, I would advise practicing on a lighter dog first. And like I said, you wanna completely wash and dry that dog. Make sure the coat is dry. I don't color damp fur. That's just me personally. And I like to brush out the entire coat. So if there are any knots in the coat, your color isn't gonna take to those areas that are knotted up. So use, for example, washing a knotted rope. Once you untie that rope, the outer part of the rope will be clean, but that middle part where the knot was, you're gonna still see dirt there. So that's the same concept that I apply when it comes to doing color. As you can see, I'm brushing his tail out. So what I would say is a clean coat, a brushed out coat, and a nice bright coat, but you can do dark coats as well. So OPAWZ made it official. We can do that now. Thank you. I wanna see. All right, so whenever I do the tail, so I can save myself time. Oh man, I hope you guys can see. Let me try. I gotta get a camera person to help me out here. Okay, so I like to lay the tail out on my aluminum foil. And I brush it to space it out. I'm gonna lower this table just a little bit. It's typically more comfortable for the dog also because they're sitting down, so they're not gonna fight as much. Can you guys see this well? I hope you can see this well. Just in case, because I don't want you to miss this. All right. So I fan out the tail. And like I said, because this is a party look, I'm gonna just throw color all over the place. And always keep paper towel next to you just in case. This is how I achieve my party look, just in case anybody wants to know how to achieve this same look. I think it's an adorable look. I call it a party look because it's, you know, it's colors all over the place. And as long as you use colors that are kind of within range of each other, and when I say within range, I'm meaning they coordinate well, then 9 times out of 10 it'll come out gorgeous. So for example, you would do blues with greens, or blues, purples, and greens, or blue and pink, or purple, pink, and yellow, or like green, orange, yellow. Just be creative with it. I'm telling you, people love creativity. And can we just give a round of applause to Esco? Like, he is such a good, his sister Jelly Bean, she's a character, but Esco is, he's such a good boy. I'm telling you, I'm a very blessed groomer. I get a lot of really sweet clients. They make my life easy. But I think they know I make them look good, so it's just like a win for win. They're like, well, you make us look good. We know after we come here, we get a lot of compliments and we get a lot of treats. So we'll tolerate you. I put him on this just in case, because I didn't want him to show out if we were being watched. So, but usually he just lays down, he relaxes, he lets me do what I need to do. I listen to my music, you know, and just go about my business. So, I'm not sure if you all can see what I'm doing right here, but for example, I'm mixing the color. So I'm doing half the length of the hair, one color, and then the other half, another color, and I'm going throughout. So the end of the tail will be green, and right above that green, it'll be a lighter blue, or it'll be the blue black, and then I'll do the green above it. So I'm just mixing everything up, so it just looks really fun, as well as the leaving a lot of the white to show. I'm gonna look at the questions in one minute. She headed out to share a coat with friends in town, but outside the door was a gift from his mom. So she reached inside and read the letter. Have a coat, old friend, because the gift is better. This is a say thank you to family. You're still a neighbor by sharing a nice gold cup. Because sharing brings us together. I'm so excited because his mom already told me. She's like, Ashley, I'm going to cry when I see them. And Esco is walking her down the aisle because her dad is really sick, unfortunately. So her dog is going to walk her down the aisle and I get to groom him. Like, this is the most official thing I've ever done. Okay, so I'm all done, guys. Let me try to answer these questions. All right. Oh, wait, hold on. I'm done. I'm done with the color. I'm about to wrap this tail up. Well, hold on. Not nice. So when I wrap, I just fold. I don't throw all of the hair in. I just fold it up. I let my color sit for an additional maybe 15 minutes after this. So what I will tend to do is I'll probably just start pre-cutting or something like that since they're already washed. And then I'm gonna rinse him off and I'm gonna come back on the live and show you guys the after. So let's see, toothbrush. Okay, hold on. Toothbrush. Oh my God, it's so high. Everybody's here. Hey guys. So many. All right, we charge by the area. We're in mixed classes. Okay, so 15 to 25. I mean, if you're doing permanent, I would definitely say up that if you're washing and drying and then putting your dog color back on. So the whole point of you have to clean them, color them, rinse them, blow dry them again. Like, you guys have to charge. At least that's what I feel. You should definitely charge for that. Thank you for the compliments. Let me see. The red, magenta, and orange, and yellow sounds beautiful. It sounds like a summer drink. toothbrushes. So that's what I said in the beginning of the seminar. You're welcome. You're welcome. Toothbrushes are much better for smaller areas because you're able to apply the color without getting it everywhere else. The bigger the brush is, if your dog has a small head, the hair, it's just going to be a hassle. So toothbrushes are small, they're convenient, and it's easier for me to apply the color using that. That's why I use toothbrushes, and I love it. But if I'm doing the legs or something like that, I will use a regular applicator brush. But when I'm doing upright ears, I always use a toothbrush. That's the trick with that one. Toothbrush and conditioner around the base area. So, okay, perfect. I'm going to jump back on live. I asked Andrea if she doesn't mind. I'm going to jump back on live in maybe 15 minutes, 20 minutes. I'm going to let this color sit for a little bit longer, and then you guys get to see the after effect of the party color. So I'm so excited, and this is what his tail looks like. So guys, thank you so much for your time. Thank you for being here, and then I'll see you in about 20 minutes. Say bye, Esco. And say bye-bye.